Well, traders, I'm going to finish my day up $16,000 and I'm not going to continue trading today. As you can see, I've got three green trades, but this is not how it started. I did have a very nice short in FSLY to start with, FSLY, but there came one loser in VRTX. Now you can see that VRTX is in green territory, but in fact it started in red. So that's my second trade that took me back to green territory in VRTX. And of course, Tesla. So end result is good, three green trades. There were several things which I believe were educational wise interesting, and I would like to talk to them about them right now. The first thing, we should start about what happened to the S&P 500. I promised to answer that. I was asked earlier, how did I know that the S&P is going to reverse? Well, I started by saying today, traders, that when you start with a big gap down, there's usually a big pressure for the upside direction. There's a lot of people who would like to possibly average down their losses, because you know, when the S&P is down, it means that the average of the stocks of the whole markets is in fact down, and therefore a lot of people are buying. That does not usually last too long, but it usually pushes the S&P higher. Now, what happens if it doesn't? Well, maybe it won't. Technically speaking, that's a thing that you'll see most of the time, not all of the time. So you can speculate that the market will start by moving higher, and then you can speculate that the market will not close the gap, but stop somewhere and start coming down. That's purely speculation, but based on experience and of course, things that usually happen in the market that is very likely to happen. So if I know that this is very likely to happen, I would expect the market to move higher and reverse somewhere. Now take a look at the green candles. One kind of dodgy, two, three, four, five. You've got all green candles over here. If I would have seen the market starting here and moving all the way to here, I would definitely call it extended to the upside. The S&P rarely moved that much without a pullback. I mean, just look at previous behavior. Look at this move up here and a pullback. Look at this move down and a pullback. Look at this move down and a pullback. Now, can this pullback be a small pullback which will take us back higher? Sure, no problem. But on a big day down, it's not very likely. It can still happen, but it's not very likely. So the market really behaved as it should have behaved. Now, at the point where you expect it to come down, you can start thinking about shorting something. If you find a stock that is relatively to the market doing something else, and now I'm going to Tesla, which was one of my trades today. Look at Tesla. Tesla was kind of going sideways. At the point where the market was still at the highs, Tesla was right over here. So why would Tesla stay over here when the S&P was in fact near the highs at the same time? Well, Tesla was relatively to the market, it was weak. It was underperforming. Now, if you watch Tesla going sideways and you look for a nice technical formation for a short, and I posted 450-250 right here for a short, then you can expect it to do well, because at the same point, you're expecting the market to come down. So you see, the market was moving higher, Tesla was going sideways, in fact, coming down a little bit, and then you expect the S&P to come down, and you look for a short which is relative to the market weak, and you short it at a nice technical formation. You know, the combination of the way of making money in the market really is first choosing the stock you like to short or long, looking at the right technical formation at the right point, you already have an advantage. The stock is at a reversal point, has a nice breakdown, has nice support here, about to break down. You think that technically speaking, it should come down, and then you add it. Add to the fact that it has a nice technical formation over there, you add to that fact that the market is expected to come down. So you see, you need to start with the market. The market is what counts, because that's where the institutional traders are. If the market's coming down, institutional traders are selling, and those who are selling Tesla will be the winning hand, will have the winning hand. So nice technical formation in Tesla, you already have more than 50%. The S&P, you expect it to come down. Of course, you need to know something about the S&P to expect it to come down, but you expect the S&P to come down, you will have a backwind now, because institutional traders are going to be with you. They'll start selling too. So you find a stock that has a nice technical formation for a short. You look at the S&P. The S&P seems to you like it's going to come down. And well, if you're not experienced enough to know that the S&P is supposed to come down, that's why you're in the trading room with us, hearing us out, you know, trying to realize what we're saying and why we're saying and learning from this. This is our job, of course. So that's the point where you would like to short a stock that has a nice technical formation. You put both together, the nice technical formation in Tesla, the fact that Tesla was not performing as the market, was actually coming down with the market, was at the highs. The fact that the market is supposed to come down, and the market did come down, and that's the whole of these ingredients together would give you a nice short trade in this case in Tesla. Anyway, it was a nice trade. The second one was also interesting. I think I had three interesting trades today, in fact. So look at VRTX, a huge gap down today. This stock was yesterday at what? 272 and started today at 228. So it lost like, I don't know, 50 points or something. So you expect a gap and go. The stock moves higher, then comes down. You remember this is 230 support that we've seen here. Once it came under 230, it looked like a perfect short. We shorted it about 50 cents slower. And I did reach my target. I did not take my partial. I was expecting it to be a very big move. Look at it now. It is a very big mover. I was expecting it here to come there, but it did not happen. Anyway, that was a loser because it did move over the highs. However, once I saw this topping tail and the fact that it was refusing to continue to move higher and remembered, of course, that the stock is relatively weak and it started with a huge gap down, therefore it's likely to gap and go, I took another chance and shorted it once more. That's why the end result is green. You know, I started with approximately $6,000 loser. So although I had a nice winner in FSLY, VRTX took me down my first trade. So I was red for a while. But then came the second trade in VRTX, and of course came Tesla. And there came another interesting trade, which was FSLY. So they all have some kind of educational point of view today. So if we're looking at at FSLY, the interesting part of FSLY was the fact that again it started with a gap down. You expect a gap and go, therefore you short it at the first reversal after it's moving higher, and it worked out fine. But then slowly, gradually, moving higher and higher and higher. It's like it's telling us, well, I did make what I was supposed to make earlier, and that was a nice partial. But then I'm giving up on this. And look at the way it's trending higher, moving higher, and then you think maybe it's going to come down again. Then moving over the recent high, and you know it will find some resistance here at the highs, of course, as it's supposed to. And then coming down again and moving up. I mean, that was enough. I mean, how many times can I see the stock moving higher and expect it to continue coming down? That point was the point where I switched directions and I moved to a long trade. I was still short 400 shares at that point. And then I was clicking the button and moving. The nice thing I can do with my new Colmex platform, by the way, is that I can click on just one button and move from short to long. I don't have a short button, I have a buy button. And that enables me to move with just one click of a button from short to long. And that turned out to be a great trade because once it moved over 90, it came up and that looks like a 4-point trade. And I'm still riding just 100 shares right now. So doing good on the long side, doing good on the short side. And you know, it's quite rare that we get a good trade in a stock both directions, once on the downside and then on the, oh, look at Tesla now, what's going on there? I'm no longer there because it took me out on 452. Anyway, I hope that was a bit more educational than usual, because I think we had some interesting things that happened today. And just wish you all the best. For me, it's a great day with over 16,000. In fact, with my open trade, just over 17,000. So got a very nice trade. I had a trading session today. Had a great session yesterday. So hope you guys enjoyed. And I'll see you all tomorrow. Thank you for participating. And don't forget to give us a thumb up if you're on YouTube. We'll appreciate that very much. I hope you guys enjoyed too. So thank you all. I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet trading room for a free 14-day trial.
Tradet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its trading room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.